Morning, guys. It's currently 8:20 a.m. I'm just leaving Kenzie's house today. Saturday, gonna be a fun, chill day. Don't really have plans. I do need to kind of get a good amount of stuff done today and tomorrow because I go out of town Thursday to Hawaii for 8 days. But yeah, the only thing actually on the agenda is later on I am going to a boxing class and I think lunch with Remy. So, looking forward to that. Gonna head home now. All right, so I just finished editing yesterday's footage, made a thumbnail that's about to go up, made my little oat milk latte, and then my lazy breakfast has just been coming in clutch every day. Gluten-free waffle, this is so weird, I eat them plain, I don't like anything on it. And then I made two of those meatless sausages.
Guys, I just realized my 24-hour room transformation video on my main channel is at 676,000 views.
My sister Madison, who helped me film that, and I are just dying because like, what, literally, I almost didn't film that video. I filmed that literally the day before, if you probably saw this, but the day before I was leaving North Carolina to come back to LA, and I was like, oh, I don't have a video, and like, I've been wanting to redo my room, so I should just do this. And like, that was like a throw together video. Like, I filmed the clips, and then actually I edited it, I think, like, rather well. And so actually the end result's okay. But like, the video itself, it was just like, I just tossed that thing together. I mean, I'm thrilled about it, but that's one thing about YouTube that's like a little frustrating is you can put so much work into something that like might just have like the wrong tagging, or like it isn't searchable, or YouTube's not showing it to people, and it can perform terribly. Or you can do something like this that literally like you didn't put any thought into and it just happened, and then it just does well. You just never know.
Thoroughly annoyed at myself. I try to get so creative and make like red, white, and blue intro and like other stuff. But this date, when I switched it from just the 4th to the 4th and the 5th, I didn't switch that one, so it's like jumping around from like that to that. Ah! And then we had a firework.
Can't wait to catch up on your vlogs. Hi.
Are you coming back tomorrow?
Only for, what?
Mm-hmm. Maybe going to San Diego.
San Diego waffle for one day. How spontaneous with me.
Rather spontaneous. I thought you were going to Spain today. That would have been a little more spontaneous.
You're right.
But
Monica didn't go, so I'm
gonna go. Hello to your wall.
Oh my gosh, yeah, it's getting worse every earthquake.
Look at Adrian's door.
Yeah.
That's not good. She's oh my blind. Gosh, that is like actually
she's
like
don't blow. My door frame's just gonna break and I'm gonna get stuck.
No, every time I come back in town, I like shut my door when I leave town, and this door frame and one of the doors downstairs, like the door frame has like gotten tight over time. Yes, this is disgusting, and this earthquake is my motivation to clean this up today. But every time I come back in town, I guess our house like settles a little more and my door gets harder to open. But after these, I'm like, can I even shut my door? We'll see.
All right, peeps. So I'm about to head to my boxing class. Wearing just a little tank from Fabletics today. Deodorant, a crucial step I nearly forgot.
Okay, so I just got to the Rumble parking garage. I'm gonna walk in a second. I'm not sure if Remy's here yet.
Yeah, just wanted to say a quick word that about the earthquakes. Well, A, this camera has a stabilization feature, so you really couldn't even see much shaking as it was in person. But B, for all the people who may or may not, but I'm seeing stuff all over Twitter, like real California in here, that was nothing. Like A, the earthquake hit, like people probably know this, it was like between here and Vegas. It was very far away, so there you can look up Ridgecrest earthquake, like that's where it happened. And it was felt like in LA and in Vegas and whatever, but there's really bad damage like where it actually happened. So feel bad for everyone who actually is like really affected, because I just felt it like slightly. Like the reason it's scary isn't because of like the like what's happened so far, because nothing's like there's been no damage, like whatever. The part that's scary is like during it, it's frightening because you don't know like is this going to be the big one everyone warns you about, like you don't know when it's going to stop. So that's what's like alarming, and why I hate them. It's not because of the actual like physical earthquakes I've experienced that haven't like resulted in anything. But anyways, yeah, I'm gonna walk in to Rumble right now, have a good little workout.
Two friends accompanying today.
This is my first Sweet Green experience.
I want to see your first impression.
Oh, I mean, to be honest, I tried it in the line.
Oh, you did?
Yeah. Okay.
I mean, it's just a kale Caesar. I thought, because we were deep in conversation, so I just wanted something that I knew what would be on. All right. Can I get an even bite? Oh.
A nice hint of lime.
Oh, yeah. What about the Parmesan crisps?
I really do enjoy the Parmesan crisps.
10 out of 10?
Yeah. Great.
Had a great workout. If you guys ever go to Rumble, recommend starting on the floor side. If the class is full enough, you can like choose if you start on like the bags or the floor. And I like starting on the floor because then you can put 100% there. And then on the bags, if you need to, you like don't. You can like control how much you're hitting it, you know what I mean? Versus like controlling whether or not you're lifting these weights on the other side. So a lot of times the classes I go to aren't like full. Then I have to start on the bags, which then I think it's probably, well, it is a better workout, but I'm like dying on the floor side. So anyways, just a random tidbit that probably applies to like 1% of you guys. But I'm now in the Trader Joe's parking lot. I'm just going to pick up a couple things, including just on an earthquake preparedness note. I feel like it's just good to have for the future because like no one anticipates these things are gonna happen, and I feel like I just need some food that can be like eaten without like having to use electricity or water or needing to be refrigerated or whatever. So just gonna like get a couple things, but also I just need to restock on a few things, and then might go in Target. I don't need anything at Target, but I just feel like I want to go there, so we'll see.
Groceries acquired. That took all of like 1 minute. I don't think I'm gonna go in Target because I literally need nothing, even though it would bring joy to my soul.
I'm so disappointed right now. What a past like 60 seconds it has been. The fluctuation of emotions, huge. I just like, I don't know why I was thinking about things I wanted to do tonight that would be fun, and I thought like, oh, a comedy show would be fun. I've been to one before. And so I looked up The Laugh Factory, and Tiffany Haddish, the queen of Girls Trip, my favorite movie. I love Tiffany Haddish so much, and she is like headlining a show at 9:30. And so I text everyone I can think of because I must attend this. And I like think I recruited someone, but then I checked to see if there were still tickets, and it's sold out. I'm so sad. I need to like research. I would die to see her. I didn't realize she was still doing stand-up. My hopes are back up. I decided to search her on Eventbrite to see like next days she was gonna be there, and she's at the Comedy Store, the like competing show or whatever place to the Laugh Factory, at 7, and there are tickets, and I must go. Oh my gosh, yes, Casey just said yes. All right, I have now showered and gotten ready. I'm about to meet up with Casey for the show. To be safe, I'm gonna leave my vlog camera at home because I could totally see this being like, this is in Hollywood, and I went before, and I feel like they were picky even about like, you couldn't take pictures on your phone or something, or maybe that's wrong. I definitely took a sneaky photo. I don't know. There are just a lot of rules at these places, and I don't want to not be able to go in because I have an actual camera. So I'll try to get some phone footage, but I'm so excited.
This girl's one of my favorite people, deserves it more than anyone. I love her. Dressing like Where's Waldo in public. Y'all see him walk through? I was like, there go Waldo.
Guys, I just got home. I can't put into words how happy I am. Every single person in that show was hilarious. There were like some people from SNL and like Comedy Central and things that I like honestly I'm not well versed on. I didn't personally know anyone, but every single person was so funny. Like, I honestly don't even think Tiffany Haddish was the funniest person, but she was my favorite to see. She was like, she was so funny. Just knowing she, I don't know, just looking at her, you know, it was like seeing an old friend, but I don't know her, but just, I felt so proud of her, you know? It was so good. We made eye contact on so many occasions. Casey and I were sitting on the second row of this place, and just really incredible. Like, it was magical. I feel like so much excitement just knowing that Tiffany Haddish and I locked eyes. What a night.
When you sit down on your own couch and find yourself tempted by an open bag of flaming hot Cheetos that just happens to be here.
All right, I'm gonna go to bed. I'm not sure how much footage I have in this video. It's been such an amazing day. I am thrilled that it just happened out of nowhere. This is probably my favorite thing about living in LA. It's just that there's just constantly so much going on. Like, I can just Google a comedy show and there were like so many famous comedians tonight, and I got to see Tiffany. Okay, anyways, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you all in tomorrow's video. Leave a comment about anything, please. Okay, bye. Good morning, guys. Happy Sunday. Wearing this shirt again. I'm telling you guys, I sleep in these like every day. I woke up in a frenzy at like 9 a.m. because I was like, oh, I'm gonna sleep in. And I woke up and realized it's Sunday and I didn't post my video yesterday. I kind of was planning on posting it Sunday. I feel like people spend more time watching YouTube on Sundays and Saturdays. Let me know. what you do. And then I like hadn't exported it or like done like a couple final little edits and like made the thumbnail and everything. So I like was planning on sleeping in a little later, and then I like jumped up and I was like, I have to finish this. So got that up a little bit ago. I just did my skincare routine. Gonna go make some breakfast finally. I'm starving. Every time I see this, I think it's cute. I think I was the one who found this. However, this incorrect punctuation drives me crazy. There was no need for there to be a period there, or if there's going to be one, there should be one after life happens. It bothers me every single time. It is quite the cloudy day out, which might be perfect to go on a walk.
Yum.
Just sat down in the office. I gotta shout it out to Adrienne for her idea behind this. I was kind of indifferent, but I wasn't like, oh yeah, I really want like an office space, whatever. But I love having this. I think it's so pretty, colorful, bright, like love having a clean space to come work in here. So I'm about to import yesterday's footage and edit this video, which I'm getting a late start on, but I feel like it might not have enough footage and it might get combined with this. At this point, you guys already know. I was just thinking about videos for this week, and I know I mentioned doing like a Hawaii trip haul because I leave on Thursday to go to Maui and Oahu, but I feel like people don't really care about like a haul for a specific place unless they're going to that place. So I was thinking maybe instead I'll just wait till Hawaii and get like cool outfit footage and do like an outfits of the week video, because like old school YouTube love outfits of the week videos, and just do like it for like vacation or Hawaii trip or whatever. I don't know. I don't know why I feel like that'd be more interesting, because I feel like people want to just like see the outfits more than they're like interested in like, oh, I need to go buy 15 floral skirts. You know what I mean? So I feel like outfits of the week could be cooler than, and like get some fun footage and stuff. I don't know, versus the haul. Let me know what you think.
Okay, so edited yesterday's vlog. It's like nine, almost 10 minutes, but like a lot of this is like not very interesting, like stuff I would cut out if I had more footage.
For today, presently for me, I know I'm not doing that much or like really anything either. So today I wouldn't have enough footage. So we're just gonna combine the two, that way less pressure, but yeah.
Watching some rally video. This girl is so good. Yes, Lisa.
These low notes.
Ooh.
All right, cooking up lunch. I had a bunch of salmon that was expiring tomorrow, so I thought I'd cook all of it and meal prep a little, I guess. And then I'm just making a bunch of veggies.
I've been sitting here for so long just watching Netflix. But I just picked this book up off my shelf that is like, we have a bunch of books over on like the shelves in the nook just for decorative purposes that I've never read, including like, we also have books here and like throughout the kitchen and stuff. So I thought I'll just sit here and peruse this.
I'm already in bed and realized my vlog camera's downstairs, so I'm gonna say goodnight. Today turned into nothing. I just chilled. I just watched a movie on Netflix with Jennifer Aniston and Adam Sandler. It was really funny. I highly recommend. It's like kind of like one of those like murder. What is that game? It's like the concept of this board game. I'm gonna go to bed. I'll pick this up tomorrow. Good night.